Blog Talk Radio. Hi, this is Rusty Schwimmer, and you're listening to Pam and Dawn on Take Two Radio.
Hello, and welcome to the special edition of Christmas Movie Spotlight. I am your host, Al Mack, and I'm here with my friend and colleague and host, Pam. Hey, Pam, how are you?
Hi, Dawn. You know what would freak people out? As if I came on and said, hello, and welcome to the special edition of Christmas Movie Spotlight. I'm your host, Pam, and I'm here with my friend, colleague, co-host,
Dawn. I mean, because, look, if we're going by the moniker Pawn, then, you know, it fits, right?
Right.
Oh, my gosh. I know, and I know people could probably say this verbatim week in, week out, but, look, it is what it is, folks. We have to acknowledge these things. But nonetheless, how are you? Have you had a good week?
I've been good, thank you. And yourself?
Yes, the tree has been lit. I'm happy as a clam. I'm sure you don't have yours up by now, but you know what? That's okay. Maybe you do, maybe you don't. Do you?
You think I would have it up and not tell you?
Absolutely not.
I would have to put it in your face and say, look what I did.
That's so true. That's so true. Like, you know, so anyway, but yeah, I'm happy. I've got my house decorated. All's well in the world for me, and just loving the tree while I'm watching Christmas movies. All these Christmas movies this year, my gosh, it's like Christmas movie explosion, but they're all so good, which we will talk about that in another show in another time. But today, Pam and I are so excited to bring you our special interview with the award-winning and incredibly talented Rusty Schwimmer.
And oh boy, is she talented and she's fun. She's my homie because she's from Chicago.
Yes, indeed.
Yes, yes. Wait, they'll laugh when they listen to this. And Rusty stars in the holiday movie Scrooge and Marley, currently on digital for the first time and available in a 10th anniversary DVD.
We are so excited and honored to bring you our interview with Rusty Schwimmer.
Enjoy the show.
Thank you so much for calling in, Rusty. We really appreciate you taking the time. We know how extremely busy you are.
Oh, my pleasure. And not too busy for you two fabulous ladies.
Ah, thank you.
Oh, that's so sweet. Thank you.
Have you figured out where Dawn and I are from? I don't normally ask this question, but there's a reason behind it, so go ahead.
Okay, so Dawn, of course, somewhere in the South, and I'm wondering if it's, and I'm pretty good with accents, and so I'm just trying to figure this out. Are you, Dawn, from South Carolina?
No, but very close. I'm in North Carolina.
Oh. You're in North Carolina. Okay,
uh-huh.
My friend, her mother, she's from North Carolina outside of Raleigh, and her mother would say, you know, because I'm from Chicago, she'd say, are you going to see your friend Rusty from Chicago?
Oh. And I can say I've never said Chicago that way to Pam. But, yeah, and I am about an hour from Raleigh. I live in a little bitty college town called Elon. And so.
Oh, I know Elon. Absolutely,
oh, yeah.
I do.
Elon,
yeah,
University,
yeah.
It's almost in my back door. I mean, I hear
football
games and the band all the time. And, you know, it's just an exciting time of year here. But, yeah, it's a great little town. But
that's
but,
fantastic.
Yeah, North Carolina is awesome. It really is. So.
That's what I hear. That's great. Yeah, and I have no clue where you're from. I have to hear you talk a little bit more, and then I could get some hints. Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
I will go ahead and ask you the first question, and then you can answer the question, and then you can maybe figure out where I'm from. Okay.
Exactly.
when did you decide you wanted to be an actress? I mean, did you grow up wanting to be in the spotlight? Is that something the little girl in you wanted to do?
Yeah, you know, I never thought about it being in the spotlight. Isn't that funny? All I really thought about is that I wanted to play dress up for a living. And I wanted to be an actress because I wanted to kind of, I was fascinated by human behavior, and I wanted to be able to, as a child, thinking I could imitate them. And then as I grew older, it was more on a social psychology aspect of it, and I've always wanted to be an actress. I grew up, that was all I wanted. And so now I'm wondering if you're from around where I'm from. That's why maybe you're asking that. Yeah. Yep.
If
so you're from the Chicago area?
I was going to say, if you can't figure out I'm from Chicago and everybody else can, I don't know what we're going to do with
you. Well, you just, as soon as you said ask and can, that's when I went, okay, now you're from, but you're not, it's the suburbs of Chicago, right?
Well, I grew up in Chicago until I was 13, and then I moved to the suburbs.
Which suburb?
Right now, I'm in Westchester.
You're in where?
Westchester.
Oh, you're in Westchester. Okay. So that's very interesting. I love that. So you grew up in Chicago. Yay! That's where I am now. I was in Los Angeles for 24 years, but then I moved back to my hometown of Chicago. Yeah.
What,
so
you could have possibly missed the weather.
I'm a redhead, so sun freaks me out. And I was miserable in Los Angeles because I was constantly with some crazy umbrella that people thought I was nuts having an umbrella while it was very sunny out. So I'm very happy to be back in Chicago with the wind and the not a lot of sun. So it's good for me. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, we could have traded. If you were going to go there, you know, we could have traded. I could have moved to your house in California, and you could have moved into mine here.
Yeah, right? Absolutely. Yeah, but I'm definitely in the city. I grew up in the suburbs, in the northern suburbs, but I love the city so much. So I'm smack dab in the middle of the city. That's where I am.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, Rusty, Pam and I are always having the proverbial conversation about the weather in Chicago, all the snow that you guys get up there, and I'm saying send it my way because in North Carolina we don't really get a lot of snow anymore. We used to once upon a time, but not so much now. And so she's like, I will gladly. I mean, after that first snowfall, she's done. But, of course, it doesn't end with one up there. Well, in the beginning of your career, did anyone give you any advice that you followed, and would you like to share with that you would like to share with other actors that are starting out?
Oh, good question, Dawn. You know, I was given this from my mother and my aunt, where they would say, "Just keep chopping the wood and don't look at the pile," and to me, that's a huge deal because everybody wants immediate gratification and things aren't going fast enough. And they don't understand that if you want to be an actor, you have to look at the long game, right? And if you want to be famous, I don't know how I can help you there, because I think the only way I can help you there is to go on a reality television show and be humiliated in public, and then you'll be famous. But but I can tell you how to probably stay in this business and continue to act, and that is basically to get as much training as possible, keep chopping the wood and look at the pin and don't look at the pile, and saying please and thank you goes a long way. And maybe this is advice for anyone going into any business, but I truly believe that that's a huge deal. It's a huge deal. And get as much training as possible. You know, that's what keeps you here.
That's great advice. You know, there's, I always wonder, is it most people in entertainment that don't have a plan B? Because it seems to me that we've spoken to quite a few people that go headstrong into this, and they're going to make it no matter what, no matter how many no's and whatever else come their way, you know, bad parts, little parts. They're just going to keep on going. So that's, you know, the best attitude to have, I guess.
Yeah, it really is. And I think that stardom is overrated. You know, friends of mine that are ridiculously famous, they have lost their public privacy. And at the same time, they understand that that's, you know, that's the side effect of what they do for a living, right? But most people I know that are doing this and continuously doing this love acting. It's the other stuff that's not as fun, that everybody else thinks is fun, like the red carpet or getting your picture taken all the time. That's not fun for most actors, most actors I know. What's the fun is being on the set or being in a play, and the camaraderie, the collaboration, that is what we all live for. That's why we keep going. That's why we always keep going after 5 million no's, you know?
right.
Yeah.
Well, I was wondering, too, you know, there's a ton of theaters in Chicago, so I bet you were kept pretty busy. What was your favorite play or musical that you were in?
Oh, geez. You know, I haven't done a lot of theater, to be honest, since I started making movies and being on television. But the last one that I did, and Pam, you're going to know probably about this if you're from Chicago, is I did a play in 2017 that's a usual holiday play called Hell Cab. And it's it's about a cab driver near Christmas picking up a whole bunch of people in Chicago. And it was the 25th year in 2017, and the playwright and I were friends, Will Kern, a great playwright. And he wanted to, you know, put the show on again during Christmas, but he wanted to do it. And this was right after the Me Too, or right before the Me Too movement. And he said, I will let you put the theater, put this on if you have a woman cab driver. And so I was the first female cab driver in Hell Cab in the 25 years it's played. So that was an honor, and I loved it.
Yeah,
it was really cool. And you stay on stage the whole time, 90 minutes, you know. You stay on stage while everyone goes in and out, and you're on stage the whole time. So that was a great challenge, amazing challenge.
And what an honor for you to be able to play that role and kind of change history from what it had been for the past 25 years.
Absolutely, Dawn. And also showing that, you know, a woman's place on stage isn't always about a woman trying to get a man or trying to, you know, best another woman. It's just a woman going through life, just like a person going through life. So that was exciting to me. So I loved it.
Yeah, and that's very true to form, because that's really how women go through life, too. You know, we're doing everyday things and any number of things, really. So that's a true-to-life portrayal as well. Pam and I are huge soap opera fans, and we know you played the role of Sister Claire on Days of Our Lives. And was your experience like on a soap opera?
Well, I say this all the time. This was the best acting class I've ever been paid for.
Yes.
I was there for, I did 5 episodes. And, you know, talk about a challenge. Oh, my gosh. You have 25 pages a day. And you have one take.
Oh, wow.
And then who am I with? like the most like famous soap opera person, Allison Sweeney, right?
You're right. Yeah.
So Allison Sweeney has been doing this since she was a child. She could do it in her sleep and is amazing at it. And I thought, uh-oh, here you go. Just hang on, get on the train and hang on. And that's basically what I did. I think I spent more time in the makeup and hair chair than I did on the stage, the sound stage. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah, well,
we're giggling
along with you because we have interviewed so many soap actors, so we know how intense it is, you know, to be on sets like that for
it's
soap.
Unbelievable.
Even if it's a short time.
Yeah, and you know, the soap actors, the ones that do it day in and day out and are in your living room every single day, these actors are so skilled, so hardworking. Unbelievable. It's amazing. It's wild. And it was incredible training to have, but I don't know if I could do it day in and day out. I don't think I could.
Well, I mean, if you got used to it, you probably could, just like they do, you know.
I don't know. I don't know. I don't think I could get all those words in my head and then spit them out in one take. It was pretty hairy there. And I must say, I didn't do a great performance, but, you know, what are you going to do?
No, you were perfectly fine. I mean, do you watch yourself when you do a role of some kind, like TV or movie or something? Do you watch yourself ever and critique yourself?
Most of the time I don't. And a lot of times people make the assumption that I don't like to see myself or hear myself. I know what I look like. I know what I sound like. That's not a big deal to me. What it is really about is the experience I had while I was doing it, while I was creating it, was so much more fun than the finished product. And so I always like to keep that memory instead of what that finished product was. But that being said, I do watch myself sometimes, especially if it's an accent that I did or a different part that I did, to see if that worked or not or translated well on film. So once in a while I'll see myself, but most of the time, no.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's really funny that you're mentioning that, because Pam and I are forever talking about, you know, I'm the one that'll go back and listen to our shows to see how we can improve what we did, you know, that sort of thing.
Sure.
And she will not listen to them. She's like, nope, once and done. And you know, and then
is that how you feel, Pam? Is that how you feel? Is that why you feel that, or you just don't want to hear yourself?
I don't want to hear myself. I don't. I think I sound like a dingbat. I don't know. I don't like listening to myself.
You don't sound like a dingbat. You sound like a good Chicago girl.
Well,
okay?
thank you for validating that, because I've been telling her this for over 10 years and she just hasn't gotten the memo yet.
Yeah, come on, Pam. Come on. Catch up here.
I need to get with that.
But, you know,
it's going to be a 10-year anniversary for my radio shows, and I just for November 10th, and you think by now I would be used to it, but no. Someday.
You're not used to it. Yeah, it happens. It happens. You know what? You're still doing well. Just take it from us. You know, take it from Dawn and I. You're doing okay.
Thank you.
Much better than my performance on Days of Our Lives. I'll tell you that. Much better. So.
Well, Pam and I are just excited about the holiday movie that is currently being promoted for you, Scrooge and Marley, where you star opposite of Tim Kazurinsky and Bruce Vilanch in this wonderful Christmas comedy. And so can you share a little bit about the movie without giving too much away?
Yes, it's, you know, the main thing about it really is it is a Christmas carol, Dickens' Christmas carol, told through the gay and queer perspective. And, what's cool about it is Dickens, who wrote A Christmas Carol, it's like Shakespeare, is timeless. So you could have like a hip hop Christmas Carol, or, you know, you've seen so many different versions of Christmas Carol, and this is just another one.
Mm-hmm.
And it's lovely because so many of my gay friends, I am a friend of the gays, and so many of my gay friends said, you know what, I would just love to have a nice, wholesome Christmas movie told about me. And here it is. And the cool thing about this is that this was filmed in 2012, or released on DVD in 2012, but
mm-hmm.
it was so much more taboo then. But because of how our world is finally kind of opening up a little bit and you know, I guess paying attention more to the people that are more marginalized or underserved, this is now more of a non-issue, and people are
mm-hmm.
much more excited. I know that the younger generation is like, yeah, so why is this different? Okay, cool. You know, it's like,
mm-hmm.
not a big deal. And so it's very exciting in that way that you can, that anybody that is gay or queer, they can see themselves in a movie that's really about love, that's about family, that's about community, and they can sit down and they don't have to substitute the love story with a gender that they don't prefer, you know, that they
right.
don't have to substitute that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of exciting. And I play, in the original version, the nephew Fred is you know, Scrooge's nephew. I am niece
mm-hmm.
Rita, so it's kind of fun in that way. So not only switching sexualities, but switching genders too, which is really exciting. So
mm-hmm.
yeah, it's cool.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
I'm sure it will go well, as you said, times have changed. So, it's a great time. Now, what has been the most rewarding part of your career?
Oh, gee. You know what? I'll be really honest. The most rewarding part of my career has been to meet all the people that I've been able to meet in my travels. I did a lot of movies that were based on real people, and I was able to be invited to be in their lives and portray them. And whether it was the iron ore workers from North Country, or the people in the fishing village of Gloucester in Perfect Storm, meeting all of the people that we were portraying has been an honor and a privilege. And I think that has been probably the coolest part for me. Really, yeah.
Well, that's, you know, and that's almost like an added bonus, like the cherry on top of the ice cream sundae, because, you know, with all the people that you meet in your profession and all the people that you intersect with that have commonality in a lot of way, it's just, I'm
right.
sure it's just been quite an experience to be able to see and meet people in so many different places doing
yeah.
what you love.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. It's really an amazing thing. Someone had asked me my definition of success, and I said being able to pay your bills by doing something that you're passionate about.
Mm-hmm.
And
oh,
so,
yeah.
You know, so I feel like it's been a great success in the sense that I've been able to travel the world, meet people I never would have met before if I were in an office or in a, you know, retail situation. And so it's been quite amazing. And, you know, not to mention, you know, it doesn't hurt to meet people like George Clooney, you know. It's,
oh, yeah.
You know, not a bad dude to meet, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So there's that. you know.
Oh, yeah. It's very rewarding. I know Pam and I talk about this all the time, but just doing the show for so long, and we've done radio for, gosh, probably as long as we've known each other. And
really?
Yeah, she's had shows. I've had shows. We've done shows together. This is our fourth season of Christmas Movie Spotlight, and just getting to be able to talk to so many people that, you know, we see on TV, in movies, and we grew up watching, even in some respects. And it's just really, we're so blessed that we've had that opportunity that not everybody gets to do. And it's just been so rewarding to just hear from so many different people how they are, you know, off screen and about their life experiences, like you're sharing. And it's a very big blessing for both of us to be able to take that in.
I love that. I love that so much. There's so much good stuff that's going on in our world. Of course, there's great polarization of things in society right now. But if we really take a look, we see that there's so much to be grateful for.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Well, before we wrap up our interview, we want to play a little lightning round. It's a five-question lightning round, and it's all Christmas-related because, of course, this is a Christmas show. And, and there are no wrong answers. I mean, we're talking about Christmas in October, but hey, you know. But nonetheless.
No, it's not October. It's not October. It's got to be November, right?
That's exactly right.
Yeah.
You know, really, Christmas is any day of the year you want it to be, because it's just it's such a great feeling and so nostalgic, and I could go on and on. I'm the one between the two of us that loves Christmas. So
that's lovely. I love it.
It's not that I don't like it. It's just Dawn celebrates year round practically.
Pretty much.
It's okay. My niece celebrates Halloween year round, and so you can imagine how she's feeling right now. You know,
I love that.
Well, the first question is: what is your favorite Christmas tradition?
Favorite Christmas tradition is waking up in the morning and having our picture taken right as we wake up in the morning, before we open up any presents or have any coffee, and we look like crap. Yeah, it's good. Yeah.
That makes for some great memories. And then the photos are for all of posterity, you know. That's just what it is. It captures the moment.
Yes, it does.
What is your favorite Christmas song?
Oh, you know what? It's Silent Night. It really is. I love it so much. I think it's such a beautiful song.
Mm-hmm. It's really hard to beat that one or top it. What is your favorite Christmas movie?
It's A Wonderful Life. Hands down.
That's one of my favorite ones as well. It's just so timeless, you know.
So beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful story.
Yep.
All right, hot toddy or hot chocolate?
Depends on the day, hour, minute. Right now, because I have to drive, hot chocolate. Okay.
Uh-huh,
but if I'm in for the evening, hot toddy. How's that?
It's like, you know, that's just why there are no wrong answers, because both can apply at any given time during not just the holiday season, but any time, really.
That is correct. Absolutely.
All right. And the last question, white lights or colored lights?
Oh, colored lights. I like color.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. So that is, I'm not one of those neat, I remember my mother was so excited. She got to put tinsel on for the first time, and she just put it on like there was no tomorrow, you know, to the point where you couldn't see any green after a while. And so I truly believe that colored lights are my jam. That's my jam.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
For sure.
That works. Like she said, there's no wrong answers, so we're good.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, Rusty, we couldn't even tell you how much fun that we had speaking with you today, and we welcome you back anytime. who looks forward to seeing your movie and anything else you have coming up would be wonderful. So check
Thank
in with
you.
Us again.
Absolutely, I will. Thank you so much. You two are absolutely delightful.
Thank you
for
your time. We've greatly enjoyed it.
Yes, and
so
since we won't be speaking to you before the holidays, be sure to enjoy the holidays and God bless.
Oh, and God bless you. Enjoy the holidays too. Take care, ladies.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Okay. Bye.
Hey, guys, don't leave us yet. Be sure to follow us on Twitter at Christmas Movies. That's XMASMUVIES. And also like our Facebook page at Christmas Movie Spotlight. Don't forget, that's spelled MUVIES. And follow us on Instagram at Christmas Movie Spotlight.
And don't forget to check out our website, ChristmasMoviesSpotlight.com. That's movies with MUVIES, ChristmasMoviesSpotlight.com.
Thanks for listening. See you next week.